throws. That show might have to be eight hours long today.
All right, we're going viral. Yesterday, the Cowboys sent shockwaves through the NFL when they picked up Amari Cooper from the Raiders in a trade. Internet comedian Cameron Magruder took us through the emotions of a Cowboy fan.
Yeah, we just traded for Amari Cooper.
We gave them a first? No, this can't be right. This can't be right. Did we get like a second round pick back? Didn't we just give up a top 10 draft pick?
We went to the Super Bowl.
We could have got Josh Gordon for a fifth.
I'd give up a 30 second ball pick, Amari Cooper.
We don't have the best track record for trading for receivers. I'm still having nightmares about that Roy Williams trade.
At least we didn't give up a first.
What did Terrence Williams do?
And a third.
Hotel altercation.
And a sixth.
He's getting cut.
And a seventh.
This is Joey Galloway all over again. He's only 24 years old. He's already been to two Pro Bowls. The Eagles offered a second round pick.
I'm glad the Eagles didn't get him. Sure.
We can't give up a first for Earl Thomas. He's the same age as Calvin Ridley.
But we can give a first for Amari Cooper.
It's like we just drafted Calvin Ridley.
We could have signed Dez for zero draft picks.
Technically, we could still sign Dez.
We got Beasley.
Is this what Dak Friendly means?
We got Gallup.
We got Cooper.
Sure.
Kind of excited about our receivers.
Doesn't matter what receiver we have, if Dak is holding on the ball for 30 seconds.
Doesn't matter what receivers we have, if Dak is getting pressured every play.
You trying to tell me Amari Cooper's not better than every receiver coming out of the draft?
What did Saban tell Jason Garrett?
On the bright side,
Cooper needed to change the scenery.
At least we can't lose next week.
I'm a grown man.
It's so great. It's so great.
He's good at these, man.
That was good.
Scooter Magruder's good at those. Shout out to him. I like those videos.
It's a lot of fun.
It was really like the distillation of this show so far.
100%.
You're same age as Calvin Ridley, but you could have done this.
You could have done our three-hour show in 35
seconds. Well done, Scooter Magruder.
Time for stories to start your morning. Lakers fell to 0-3 with an overtime loss to the Spurs last night. However, Kyle Kuzma shined, scoring 37 points as he replaced Brandon Ingram in the starting lineup. Nick, what did you make of Kuzma's performance?
He was outstanding. They were in the second half. He was very good in the first half as well. In the second half, they went to the typical LeBron offense. Let's just do high pick and roll and let LeBron figure it out. Nobody benefited from that more than Kyle Kuzma, as you see right there. He was excellent. Right now, see, this moment, he might be better than Brandon Ingram. But they got to see how Brandon Ingram can develop. So Ingram's going to take that starting spot back from him.
Yeah, he's a better offensive player. He's got better range than him. I believe he's a better long-term fit. The Lakers got problems, man, trying to get these guys, because they got two guys who are really threes with LeBron compared to being fours. LeBron's really not ready to be a full-time four yet.
They don't have enough front court depth. In the one spot they have depth, they got two guys play the same position.
On to the NFL now, where Blake Bortles already won his starting job back. That took about 5 minutes. He'll be the starter as the Jags face the Eagles in London on Sunday. However, he'll reportedly be on a short leash. CC, did the Jags make the right move going back to Bortles?
I wouldn't even call it a leash. Like, he's on something.
A shot collar?
Yeah, he's on something. But they stuck with him. They stuck with him, man. That's just like you getting into a relationship and you love the girl and she got a dog. Hey, listen, if you love that girl, you stuck with that dog. Wait. Jacksonville. That's happened to be your quarterback.
Wait, Blake Bortles is the dog?
No, he's the girlfriend.
No, she can't be.
He's the girlfriend.
No,
he's definitely the dog.
Listen, I would have tried out the little Pomeranian I have, Cody Kessler, to see what he can do over in London.
Oh, stop.
I understand you believe in Blake Bortles that somehow when he crosses the Atlantic, he turns into some magical different quarterback, and history suggests
he does.
There might be something there. But you can't, Doug Marrone, say it's a competition on Sunday and then Monday before y'all have practiced say who won the competition. That ain't right. Blake Bortles, 7 turnovers the last 3 weeks. Maybe
last time Cody Kessler won a competition was high school. All right? Doug Marrone got it right. He lost it before it started.
All right, Monday Night Football last night. Big stage for Odell and the Giants and Matt Ryan and the Falcons, and a slow start for both teams. But in the second quarter, the Falcons opened up the scoring, a 47-yard pass to Marvin Hall. In the third, fourth and goal, Eli pressured all night, can't find anyone. Pat Shurmur, head coach, very much not pleased. I'm very much not pleased. Odell was right there. Fourth quarter, Tevin Coleman puts the game away with a 30-yard run. Falcons hold on to win 23-20. Giants now 1-6 on the year. Here's Eli Manning.
With the way we've worked and the players we have, and obviously disappointed. And but that's what happens in this league if you don't play to the caliber that you can. And we're not doing that.
All right, guys, what do you think? Time for the Giants to move on from Eli Manning?
If they got a time machine and they can do it back in this offseason, yes. But since they don't and they're stuck with him, I don't think you go to Kyle LaLetta with 9 games left, because then you don't have anyone to go move on when LaLetta likely stinks as a rookie mid-round draft pick. Like, mm-hmm. You got to stick with him for now. But Eli, yesterday is a perfect example as to why it's important to actually watch these games and not just look at the box score. If you didn't watch Monday Night Football, you'd like, wow, Eli completed almost 75% of his passes, a yard shy of 400, a 114 rating. Okay, that's great, but he was not. He missed Odell on a touchdown early. The announcer says because Odell ran the wrong route. It looked to me like Odell was wide open. He missed Odell on a touchdown late where he didn't even look to him, where you saw, we showed it, Pat Shurmur saying, throw it to Odell. And then at the end of the game, the Giants were very long shot underdogs. They're down 11, though. They have the ball at the 14-yard line with a minute 40 left. Mm-hmm. They run 2 plays over the middle with no timeouts. They get first and goal from the 1 with a minute left. And Eli seemingly goes rogue and runs consecutive sneaks to where they end up scoring with 5 seconds left and the game's over. I thought Eli was bad yesterday. I don't think he was the biggest part of their problem yesterday, but he was part of the problem yesterday.
Yeah, Eli's a problem. And ultimately, I'm going to give him several more games, Jenna. I can't get off of Eli. He has put 2 Super Bowl trophies, but we've been more than generous with Eli. Last year, we gave the coach a hard time when he benched him to stop his streak, which I didn't think was the right thing to do. With all the injuries that the team had taken on, the defense wasn't. I didn't think Eli was he shouldn't be the excuse for the Giants season going up in flames. But last night, you can see this team couldn't go anywhere. Like, if their defense was real, real good, would Eli still be the quarterback for your team? Like, you would allow him to keep playing, but you know he'd have to be in a manageable situation. In the NFL now, the yards and stuff are easy to come by, so you do have to watch the game to be able to figure out what really happened. Eli is not a force multiplier. Eli is a good teammate, but he is not a dynamic leader. And on this type of team, when you have someone like Odell Beckham, you don't have a defense that's going to support you. You could see in the press conference, Matty Ice, what he said after the game compared to what Eli. He's had a great career. There's nothing wrong with it. The biggest problem with the NFL sometimes is, how do I get out? And that's Eli's biggest problem now. Because sometimes you get knocked out. Sometimes you get benched out. None of them are really, no one really goes out on their terms. Like, that's some myth that we have. John Elway, he walked off into the sunset. John Elway couldn't play no more. Oh, Peyton Manning, he walked off into the sunset. Peyton Manning couldn't play no more.
He got benched that year. I mean, like, Barry Sanders and Calvin Johnson, just the Lions beat the football out of them, so they said, I'm done with this. Like, they didn't, that's not really on their terms. They just got sick of losing in Detroit. Like, it's hard, man. And usually guys, when they play at this level, they have football taken away from them. When you're Eli, when you're a legend, when you've won 2 Super Bowls, they're not taking it away from you. And so sometimes you got to give it up.
Well, they gave him another year this year, and guys who were pretty smart, pretty good at football in the Giants organization thought that he could at least get through the year, but it looks like
they were wrong, and I was wrong. I thought Eli had it in him for another year and thought they should go with him. I admit, I'm wrong.
All right, big night tonight.